to boldly go where no man has gone before. That feels like what Printrbot is going for with how they've set up the Printrbot Simple Pro. In many ways, it is the best Printrbot that's ever been made. In others, it's one step forward, two steps back. So let's check out what they did right and whether the bold move of going all cloud-based is paying off. So where do we start? Well, I guess at the basics. The Printrbot Simple Pro is a $999 US-made 3D printer. It sports a 150 by 200 millimeter build area that is 6 by 8 inches. The entire machine is built from solid metal, which is either powder-coated steel or aluminum, or these massive machined aluminum CNC'd part, which I believe Printrbot actually machined themselves. It's the most solid Printrbot I've ever used, and even compared to your standard i3 frames or other common 3D printers, the Simple Pro feels like a much sturdier setup. It's definitely the most well-built Printrbot I've ever used. On the front, you can see the centerpiece of the entire operation, which is a small LCD touchscreen. It's the only way the printer is intended to be used. I mean, okay, they added the functionality to just plug this printer into a USB port on your computer and use it that way, but that's more of a if you really have to backup solution. Instead, you're supposed to connect the printer to your home Wi-Fi and send it files through the printrbot.cloud web interface. And that's really the front and center part of the Printrbot Simple Pro experience. Now, when you get the machine, you are going to get it as a mostly assembled package. It's only a handful of screws to tighten and a few connectors to plug in to combine the base, the vertical axis, and the print bed into a finished 3D printer. You plug in the 60 watt power supply and pick a file from the ones that are preloaded on the machine. Maybe you'll need to adjust the nozzle height slightly, but since the Simple Pro is using an inductive bed sensor, which Printrbot calibrate before shipping the machine out, it's only going to be tiny adjustments maybe. And you've got a 3D printer that prints quite well, actually. Print quality is fantastic. The sturdy frame, dual gear extruder, and the 0.3mm UBIS 13S hot end really work together well. Now, I've also assembled the Simple Pro as a total kit. Disclaimer, you cannot buy it as a kit. I don't think the assembly is the most enjoyable one in the first place, so you're not missing out on much. Now, one thing we really, really need to talk about is the printer's interface and the web cloud service. There's some good ideas in there, but overall it's still pretty bad. So you start your setup process of the machine by getting it onto your Wi-Fi. There seem to be two different ways of doing that. Either you do it sort of manually by connecting to the Wi-Fi the printer creates, going to the IP address your printer shows, and then punching in your Wi-Fi details there. Or going through sort of a mini assistant on wifisetup.printrbot.cloud. Same result. Getting the printer connected usually works fine. It only supports 2.4 GHz networks. That's okay. But what took me quite a while at times is getting the printrbot.cloud website to actually see the printer. On a few occasions, I was seeing the printer on my Wi-Fi. I was able to ping it and all, but the web interface didn't actually detect the printer as connected. And in that case, it's just very little you can do other than trying again until it just happens to work. Once it's logged in, it works fine, but getting there isn't super straightforward. The web interface itself is actually really simple. You have your overview of projects you've created. A project is basically just a set of 3D printable parts. And for each of those parts, you can rotate it, you can set the resolution, and that's it. There's no scaling, no moving, nothing else. I thought at some point I was able to also enable support and set the infill ratio, but that doesn't seem to be the case anymore. Materials are actually independent of the print files, and while you can configure them on the web interface, you actually select them on the printer itself. You then send the project off to the printer, and the rest happens there. Now, this all sounds fine and dandy, but I do have a few issues with it. First of all, everything is really, really slow. You upload a file, then it generates a preview and the G-code, and that can take from a few seconds for really simple parts to 10 or 15 minutes if your model is even remotely complex. Then you send the file to the printer, that's fairly fast, but that didn't actually send the print files yet, that just sent the project overview. Because once you start a print, there's another download process that, again, can easily take another 10 minutes or so until the actual print starts. I mean, I'd be okay with that, but overall, printing something requires attention from you here, to upload, here to send to the printer and start the print, and then here again when the actual print starts to just, you know, have a quick look at the first layer. In a fraction of the time, I could slice a file on my computer, grab an SD card, and physically walk that to a 3D printer. But there's no SD card slot on the Printrbot Simple Pro. It's either Wi-Fi only or tethered to a computer with USB. Now, to me, as someone who works with 3D printers for a living, I see a lot of things that just could have been done better. Given the choice of a 3D printer with fewer of the fancy cloud-driven features, no touchscreen, no nothing, and the Printrbot Simple Pro, I would not pick the Simple Pro. Don't get me wrong, I'd happily use a modern interface as long as it works, it's fast and reliable, but the Simple Pro with Printrbot.cloud to me just doesn't feel like that yet. Then again, I'm not the target demographic, I'm already way too deep into it. And I know Brooke Drum, founder and CEO of Printrbot, does agree with me here. So I decided to do something a little different. I gave this printer to my little sister and observed how she'd get along with it. Who are you?
I am your sister, Isabella.
Have you ever used one of these?
Never.
Okay, so you're 11, you've never used one of these. Did you have fun?
Yeah, it was super fun.
What was your favorite part?
I think it was making fidget spinners.
You made the fidget spinners?
Yeah.
You made all of the fidget spinners, obviously.
Yeah.
And these are helpful how? Exactly. So you had this machine for a school project?
Yes, I did.
What was that all about?
So, for my school project, it was actually an exhibition. One thing was a fourth grade teacher needed a brain.
Did that work well?
Yeah, but 5% of the time, we had a few problems. So, like, one problem was when it was saying on the screen, like, unknown error, but you just have to turn off the printer and then you turn it back on and then it works fine.
So that only ever happened before or after print? When it was actually printing, once it started to print, would that ever just fail for like an unknown error or something?
No. Then there was another problem. So there was like on this little screen right here, there are like rainbow stripes all over the place.
Wouldn't do anything, touches didn't work, turning it on and off didn't work. And supposedly that there was no update notification or anything. That sounds like the printer was trying to do an update on its own. And when it turned it off in that process, which can take 10 or 15 minutes, that's when you're going to end up with a printer that is bricked like that.
To be fair, Printrbot are very vocal about you not turning off the Simple Pro during an update process. And I'm not exactly sure what went wrong here.
So how did you fix that?
I asked my dad, and so he just opened this.
Yeah, you take off the bed, you take off the LCD, there's a little SD card in here, you basically swap out a few files and then it starts working again. So this right here, this is the usable build area. It's 6 by 8 inches on the surface right here. Did you ever run out of space on this one?
Never, actually. Never.
So 6 by 8 inches, perfectly fine. And the good thing is it's not a square. So if you have something that is a bit longer in one direction, you can orient it like this. What would be the things that you'd like this thing to be better at?
Maybe sometimes when you like go on the settings and you do all the things to make it print, it kind of takes a long time because it has to like download and everything.
Would you paint it any other way?
Maybe I would want to add like blue racing stripes.
So Brooke, pay attention. This is like prime feedback right here. You want to sail these with blue racing stripes all over the printer.
And then maybe like between like a little tiny dolphin.
So closing thoughts, would you recommend this printer to a friend?
Yes.
How many stars out of 5?
I would probably say like 4.5.
4.5? That's decent. That's pretty good. Okay. Thank you for your time and your thoughts on the Printrbot Simple Pro.
You're welcome.
And then we're going to have laser beam shoot out of this and just have a... So even though there are a few shortcomings, it can work. I'm still not quite sure what applications would profit from the slow but high detail 0.3mm nozzle, the sturdy construction but no heated bed by default, and a simplified and low feature web and Wi-Fi only interface. But you tell me, I don't know everyone's requirements. So to sum things up, mechanically the Printrbot Simple Pro is extremely well built, there's no doubt about that. It prints well, and while I don't think Printrbot.cloud is quite good enough yet, let's say that I do see potential. As of right now, that is July 2017, I would certainly recommend double checking that the way you're supposed to use the Simple Pro fits within your personal expectations. It doesn't quite resonate with what I personally expect from a user experience, but that's fine, software can be updated. If you do want to grab one, links are in the video description. And today I want to give special thanks to my patrons, whose support allows me to create independent content and share my unfiltered experiences with you. I've never charged manufacturers for reviews and never will. I don't get paid by anyone to change my opinion on things, and your support on Patreon makes that possible. In particular, I want to give a shout out to Bobby CC Wong, Open Ballistics, Rudolf Wang, Maker Parts, William Divine, Matthew Bird, Stephanie Davis, Robert Monaki, Jordi Böhme, and Woody Boyd. If you want to get involved, head over to Patreon. We're doing monthly Q&A hangouts and some other stuff there. But even just subscribing would be awesome. If you do hit that bell, you'll get a notification when new content gets uploaded. So, have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.